Hi, let's discuss the solution of a given question here. What is the given question? The probability of getting a total of 9 at least twice in 6 tosses of a pair of dice is. But they have provided the options. See, once after observing the options, clearly all options are belongs to binomial distribution. Binomial distribution, what is the binomial distribution? Let me write and then we'll think about. Clearly, the random variable in the given probability distribution follows a binomial distribution. Solution. What is the binomial distribution? First let me write and then we will think about the parameters. See here, what is the binomial distribution? Probability of getting x number of success equals to n c x into p power x into q power n minus x, where x equals to 0, 1, 2 and so on. Depends number of trials, number of success in a given out of n trials. So here clearly what they have given, what is p, what is n, we have to find out. Here the probability of getting a total of 9. So we have to calculate getting a total of 9 when 2 dice are thrown. So what are the possible options? That is P here. How many tries they? At least twice means we have to calculate probability of x greater than or equal. At least twice means x should be, minimum value of x should be 2 or more than 2. So next in 6 tosses. So clearly given n equals to 6. And next, yeah, now we have to calculate the probability of getting sum. Probability of getting sum equals to how much? 9. When 2 dice are thrown, we have to calculate this value. So when 2 dice are thrown, what are the possibilities to get a sum 9? So let me write the possibilities here. One possibility is 4 comma 5 and another possibility is 5 comma 4. And if you take 6 comma 3 and another possibility 3 comma 6, is there any other possibilities like that 5? 5, 4 we wrote, to 6, 3 we wrote, and 7 it is not possible. If you take 2, okay, 7 is not possible. So only these are the possibilities. So how many possibilities, how many favorable cases are there? Total number of favorable cases equals to 4. But when 2 dice are thrown, then what are the total number of outcomes? 36. So therefore, probability of getting some 9 equals to how much? 4 by 36, which is equals to 1 by 9. So I calculated the value of P also. Then what is the value of Q? Q equals to 1 minus 1 by 9, which is equals to 8 by 9. So therefore, probability, see, mass function of a binomial distribution, that is P of X equals to NCXN 6CX, 6CX. And next, P. P means how much here? 1 by 9 whole power X, and Q means 8 by 9. Whole power how much? N minus N means how much? 6 minus X. This is the probability mass function of a binomial distribution. This is the mass function of a binomial distribution. Now what we need to calculate? See, getting a total of 9 at least twice in 6 tries means at least 2, means probability of X greater than or equal to 2 we have to calculate. Probability of X greater than or equal to 2 means, let me write probability of X equals to 2 plus probability of x equals to 3 plus probability of x equals to 4, right? Plus probability of x equals to 5 plus probability of x equals to 6. Now, which can be written as in a summation form, summation x equals to 2 to 6. So, what is that probability function here? Here means 6CXP means 1 by 9, right? Here, 1 by 9 whole power x into 8 by 9 whole power how much? N minus x means n is equal to how much they have given? 6. So this is the required conclusion. And now let's compare with the given options. What are the given options here? So 6 into, no, this is incorrect. See, minimum at least 2 means, so yeah, summation is there. So 1 minus summation means, so no, this is also incorrect. 1 minus probability of x equals to 0, 1 like that you can take. This is also incorrect. See, exactly this one, x starts from 2 to 6, 6x, 1 by 9 whole power x into 8 by 9 whole power 6 minus x. This is the correct option. So, this is the final conclusion. Now, what is the procedure we applied here? Simply, we wrote binomial distribution and then we found the parameters n value and p value. From that also, we calculated q value also. Finally, we have to calculate the probability of x greater than or equal to 2 means at least 2 times to get a sum 9. Thanks for watching. All the best.